Hello everyone, hope you're doing well. So we're back at the Nuka-World Red Rocket. Now I have plans for this place, great plans do I have. So basically this video is going to be me building kind of the main drinking hall area, kind of drinking hall, drinking stop. I've called it the, what have I called it? The Cap House, spoiler. But yeah, I called it the Cap House. Not a very good name, to be honest. I thought it was cool, you know, Cappy Cap House. It's all right. So like the whole premise for this video, and I'm obviously I've got a kind of normal speed tour at the end. Was that I wanted it to kind of look like it was open, but also busy in terms of the detail going. You know, you probably noticed already. There's a kind of a theme with I'm trying to. This is just my certain kind of interest right now, I guess, in terms of building, is kind of like just trying to add detail where there wasn't detail before, as well as making kind of interesting structures. So this one's quite open, and I've tried to mix kind of this barn format with then also a bit of the greenhouses to kind of give a like a little kind of glass area in the front. I'm quite pleased with it, and I've also decorated a wee bit at the end as well, so hopefully you like that. While we're doing this little slightly boring part, yes, I'm well aware of Bethesda's announcement regarding PS4 mods. I didn't make a video on it, one, because everyone was making a video, and two, to be utterly honest, everyone just seemed really upset, and I couldn't be asked to kind of, I knew exactly how everyone was going to react, and it was a case of people are mad. I understand why people are mad. I'm disappointed, but I'm probably not as mad as some of you. I just thought, you know what, I'll just let you guys have your weekend off and kind of chill out. Just my kind of, people keep asking, no, I'm not going to be moving over to Xbox or PC. I've mentioned this quite a lot of times before, but we're kind of quite far in the life cycle of Fallout 4 right now, and it just seems a little bit counterproductive for me to suddenly switch over to a completely new platform this far into the development cycle, kind of the life cycle, I guess, of the game. But also alongside that as well, you know, so many of you are still on PS4, and I just kind of would be pointless for me to kind of isolate quite a large portion of my audience for the sake of moving mods that, to be honest, I personally wouldn't have used very much anyway. The only reason I used it for is just for, like, it's just little bits and pieces. I quite like the vanilla items. It kind of gives me quite an enjoyable challenge. And also, to be honest as well, having mods doesn't magically make your builds better, as a lot of you know. It's just kind of how you use the items. So this is my stance of it. I'm kind of like, it's a very dumb move by Sony. Really thick. Which will be entertaining. Weird as well, considering they've always been considered the more kind of, you know, player-friendly console, and they seem to be just kind of thinking, right, you know, that goodwill that we've endeared over quite a reasonably decent period. Just remember when E3, when both the consoles were announced? Whoa, they were made so much more popular. Now they've kind of just losing it. So this will be an entertaining situation to see how it pans out. Anywho, enough of that. As you can see here, I've made the kind of opening quite open. And I wanted to kind of mix it out. I've kept it quite trashy as well. Because the fact is, even though I personally have decided to murder all of the raiders and kind of going for a bit more, well, this is my Minutemen settlement, basically. I have decided to kind of try and push home the scrappier, junkier vibe of the settlement, because I know a lot of you are going with the raiders, and I guess you can maybe incorporate some of the ideas into slightly raidery settlements. Though obviously, as I haven't done any of the raider quests, you know, beyond just clearing out the actual parks, I don't have any of their shops or anything like that, so you'll have to just do without them, or just replace what I've built. Quite a few interesting builds, actually. Those of you remember my slog video, and I have the wee little tank. What's it called? What have I called it? The fish tank for the generator. I'm going to be building a little build on that. Potentially might be the next one. And I've also got my Harambe Shrine. I need to pop here somewhere as well. So we've got quite a lot to do. I'm quite excited. I'm also really pleased we've done with the DLC. You've got months. You've got until probably January before I think when I would start, like, I actually have to stop doing Fallout stuff because I wouldn't have anything else to do. So you've got, like, months of stuff. For those of you who enjoy Fallout, you're good. But it's nice to now, in a way, kind of not have a DLC release decide what videos I'm making, if you know what I mean. And I can just go, yeah, let's make shit. And it'll be fun. So I'm quite pleased by this. You may notice I'm using the Nuka-Cola bottle here. I like, even though, like, I do like the destroyed ones, this big one, you can rug glitch it, which is awesome. I didn't realize, I wasn't sure if you were, you can rug glitch it, so that's grand. But also, it's a nice contrast. It's like, it's almost like just a kind of, well, it is just a giant piece of decoration. So I kind of liked the contrast between this and all of the kind of warehouse pieces. So I'm quite pleased. I wasn't too sure if this would look good. And also contrast nicely as well with the, obviously, destroyed bottles I have nearby. So all in all, oh, I fall down so much because I keep forgetting there's like holes. Look, watch this, I fall down. yeah, that's good fun, that. Good fun, but it's all right. It's all right. Oh, I'm getting my new microphone this Friday, by the way. Friday, Saturday. So soon, at the end of the week, you'll actually hear me in... I don't know how much, but I should sound a lot better. I'll actually have a proper pop filter as well, not a sock. And I won't be wearing a headset that occasionally wobbles around a little bit and just generally cracks. But I will actually be wearing a headset, but it won't be attached to my microphone. So you'll have me. Oh, I'm getting a Blue Yeti, by the way. That one that every other YouTuber has on the planet, which would be good. And I'm also going to hopefully get some soundproofing so my voice will not echo. The only thing you'll have to worry about then is me just slurring my words, or the occasional police siren, as this is East London. So you can see right here, like, I really like this look, of it just being a bit open. I do kind of, this is me just kind of pondering, decoration-wise. I keep the decoration, as always, I keep it kind of a little bit minimal, for the builds, just because of the fact that I know I'm going to probably do a lot of decoration later on. I did decorate this one a little bit more than I would probably potentially normally, for these kind of builds. The reason being is I wanted to kind of give you guys an idea of how this space might be used. Plus, I was just legitimately curious. I've also realized I've got to actually start doing a build with the new shop stalls. Like, I used one of these in there, but I actually just plop it straight down. I realized I need to actually kind of devise a couple of... It'll be fun little video as well. You know, we can do kind of, you know, the three shops kind of video. But does that devise an interesting build using the new shop pieces? So that's on my horizon now as well. I'm quite pleased. It's weird. Even though I'm a bit depressed there is no DLC, I'm quite pleased because I keep thinking that we have just all of this free time, I guess, without, you know, because I'm always this thing where I have this kind of like mental time limit in my head for when we actually have to finish the build. And just in terms of like, oh, the next DLC is coming out soon. Now that we don't have that, it's weird. I like it. I'm quite pleased. I'm depressed, but pleased. It's a weird, I'm going for an emotional time right now, basically. You'll be fine. You'll be all right. As I said, so we're going to be doing this settlement quite a bit. But also what I'm going to do to keep myself a little bit sane and also just to kind of mix it up a little bit, we will be popping back to the Commonwealth to do a few more building while this one's building up. Because it's quite a big place, so I don't intend to finish it in one big go. What I am going to do with the building, though, is probably spread them out so it ostensibly looks like it's finished at times, but we can always add more to it because it's such a huge area as well. Similar to, you know, I've, you know, popped back to Starlight or popped back to County Crossing, that kind of situation. I am going to see about finishing the walls at some point as well. I'll probably just slam that into an et al video where I just kind of just tidy, shall we say. This is me just having a think. I possibly should have cut all this out, but, you know, I didn't think that far ahead because evidently I'm a bit of a mong. I'm going to be... soon as well, just around to the channel, I'm going to be trying to actually, now that my new PC is set up, I've recently got my desk, I'm going to start doing some new other game content as well. I'll try and do, rather than being one of those asshole channels who just immediately aggressively switched new content, I'll try and just do these videos on top of the normal schedule of Fallout videos, and then maybe in a month or two we can slowly reduce the Fallout videos a little bit, just so I can start improving new content. So you might mean that you some weeks you'll have like 7-8 videos or something where I'm like, I want to do this, but that'll probably at least start next week, just as an FYI. But yeah, I'm going to try and ease people into it rather than just going, right, Fallout's gone now. Time for Overwatch videos or whatever. As always, I do love my reverse junk fences. I will stop abusing this one so much. I'll try and stop doing it as much. But they're just so good, all right? They're so good. They just always work. I had a little bit of an issue with this one, actually, as you can see here. I'm going to place this one down a sec. One, for starters, I completely fucked this one up, and it wasn't... Freaking got to pay attention, Davey, you dickhead. But also, it's just a little bit There's a gap at the side. Now I do cut. Now in this one, I've actually cut out quite a bit of my mistakes on me going back and kind of changing an idea. But initially, I'd put another junk fence on the side and looking awful. And instead opted for using some of the warehouse pieces. Warehouse pieces are really, when combined with the rug glitch, and I'm gonna try and I use them a lot more in this video, and I'm gonna try and force myself to use them a lot more throughout other builds because they're really useful for patching up holes or patching up gaps, like changing or just fixing or adding texture to things. The warehouse pieces have a lot of utility, which I feel I haven't used as much as I could have, for just kind of plugging bits or kind of capping ends of structures as well. It's very, very cool, and I'm quite pleased I kind of made use of the warehouse pieces in this video quite a lot. It's quite pleasing little build, actually. So you can see in a sec. Yeah, so basically I cut up, because initially what I'd used the actual tires junk fences, and it just looked awful, like it looked so bad. So instead, these bits here are amazing for capping off structures. As you can see in a second, I use these quite a lot in this. I use them once more, I think, down the front. Because I make a weird entrance to this, and I actually spent most of my time today fiddling around with, because I wanted, when any build, like when you're doing something like this, think about it as, when I've mentioned before I do settlements about set pieces, think about how can I add a set piece into this structure? Like, how can I think, okay, this is potentially a bland structure, ostensibly. So what I need to do to kind of make it look like, oh, that looks really cool, is just add this kind of set piece element to it. I had such trouble with this one because that stupid fucking junk fence with its stupid tire ruined everything, so I had to take the stupid junk fence off because it's a prick and I hate it. Die, junk fence. Anyway, yeah, my ranting about junk fences aside. So yeah, it's like, it's quite fun to kind of experiment with different ways of doing set pieces. And like, some of you guys have really started doing it as well. Like, some of the stuff people send me, that they've kind of like got the idea of this set piece. And it's quite fun to experiment with. Like, this is quite a... Have I put round the wrong way? Do I even change this? I've literally just realized, guys, that I don't fix that. And I don't realize that. I have not realized I have that junk fence around the wrong way. Oops. How did I not notice that? Oh, well, it adds a bit more character, I guess. So here's my entrance. I'm quite pleased with my entrance. This took me a while. You're going to see lots of screwing around, shall we say, with me kind of going, right, what works, what works, what doesn't work. I'm trying to think what I do now. What order do I do it in? Oh, yeah, yeah, okay, okay. So this part, for starters, took me absolutely ages because I overcomplicated it. So what I'm doing right here is I'm using... Because I could put... I can't put, like, a barn piece. Like, as in kind of a long barn piece over there. Or your character won't be able to walk through. And plus, it'll just look a little bit lame. Like, the ceiling will be a bit low. So I rug glitch this in. Now, I deliberately do have it, so a bit of... I wanted, like, the lip... of the, there we go, so you can just see the wood, because it just cuts it off quite nicely, and it turns it into a sign. But I also thought it would look really boring, you know, just having that up there like that. So what I do is I put a little bit of wire mesh from the fences. Now, this is something I want to start using as well, because it's almost like adding barbed wire. Annoyingly, because of the unevenness of the ground, a little bit, I have a little trouble, because you can actually glitch these right into each other. As you can see right now, the problem is it's the angle I put it, so I just... There we go. Now it's the right height. You want them in line with each other. So they're meshed in together. And then what I've gone and done, and I've just basically... I put it behind that sign. And it just adds a little bit of just mesh texture. And I'm going to try and do this a lot more. I have a bit of trouble getting this in. Give me a minute, yeah? Give me a minute. Go a little bit down. Down. No, it was going down, but I have to raise the pillar up. So there we go. Beautiful. And my character can walk through it, and it just adds this kind of nice little bit of a mesh texture. And that's where the sign for the actual, it's called the cap house. That's where the actual sign for the place is going to be. Now, I actually scrapped this idea, and I could have maybe done this from the start. I eventually changed my mind completely. But I think maybe it would be nice to actually add that texture in. You see, I'm doing it now, and it just doesn't really work. I thought it'd be cool just to kind of add a bit more. And I do like doing that, just kind of like adding a bit more bits to it, but it doesn't really work. So I just scrapped the whole idea completely. But it's nice to see me experiment, isn't it? And fail miserably. Because fuck my life. I probably, were I patient enough, I could have done that, but I just thought, bugger this. Bugger this. Also, alongside not storing a pillar, I do need just, like, a pair of wooden stairs on hand for things like this. Because I always... I've got so many built stairs. I just literally build, like, when I'm doing a settlement, right? I have so many stairs. Like, that one, I deliberately went, no, I'm not going to waste resources. I'm just going to go back to my workshop. But so often do I build something, and I have, like, just one of each kind of stairs, because I just happen to build the stairs closest in the menu. Yeah, I'm a bit of a knob, really. So you get these kind of cap ends. You know, watch this. It's really... It just works, people. Yeah, you pop it there like that. And you've got the text you've added to the top. And it just... Again, it's just like... It's adding a set piece entrance to what is ostensibly kind of a bit of a bland... Or it was initially looking like a bland structure. That's why I built the whole... Like, most of this video is actually me being screwing around with these little details which give this structure its character. And that's what I tried to do. Like, I started, like, I want it to look like this, but now I have to make what I've made look a lot more interesting. So we're just going to add a few, and you can see my character can run through. It's all very grand, just adding a little bits and pieces. But this is, like, a nearly ostensibly the structure's done now. It's got a little bit more texture, and I think you'll like the how I've decorated the tour. I've kept it quite minimal, as I put these railings here. But it's just quite a... I like it. And this could be any kind of bar that you like. I'm just going to pop a couple of... Yeah, I'm going to sink these in. This is quite a fun technique here. Similar with what I've done with the range. But now, initially I put this together and you could do it like that. But I love doing shit like this. Just like... Okay, that one was a little bit too long and it looks a little bit shit. But then I just put a single one in. But it looks cool and I'm quite pleased with it. Look at that entrance. Ah, oh, it looks so good. I need to try and do a couple more. I've got so many, like, things planned now. For kind of, like, now that we've finished the DLCs and I can kind of just focus on just trying new shit. That's why I'm going to go to... I'm going to be doing them at other settlements as well. Like, entrances to settlements. Like, gatehouses are a really fun set piece for a settlement. And, like, kind of all the kind of weird and wonderful stuff you can make. So, well, there we go. That is the complete structure now. Take the stairs down. Voila! There you go, guys. The cap house. I hope you liked that. I hope you enjoyed that. As I said, I'm going to be having... We're back to kind of normal schedule videos now. I just took a little bit of break over the weekend. I'll have another video potentially tomorrow, the day afterwards, on either this. I'm not too sure what I'll be doing next. As always, follow me on Twitter, @norespawns, if you want to see what I'm up to, or kind of show me what you've made as well, especially in terms of what you've made in this area. I'm quite curious. Anyway, I'll talk to you lovely people soon. You take care.